the NIST Cloud Computing Reference Architecture. This is another resource from the National Institute of Standards and Technology, and the whole point of having a reference architecture is to have a template for how NIST believes people should build out the cloud. Now, this is quite a formal definition of cloud, but it's worthwhile understanding because NIST does tend to be a pretty canonical resource for describing how things like the cloud should actually work. Let's go and have a look at what goes into that reference architecture. Here's how NIST views cloud, and we're going to touch on five key elements here in the diagram. The first one is the cloud consumer, and inevitably in this case they're talking about who is actually consuming these services. So which person or organization is actually using the cloud? Next up is the cloud provider, and obviously this is where the bulk of their definition goes. Now, this is inevitably the organization providing the cloud services. And you can see within here we've got those service layer definitions we just looked at, IaaS, PaaS, and SaaS, as well as the underlying physical resource layer and how the services are actually abstracted away from it. We've got cloud service management, security, and privacy, and we'll particularly talk about those last two points as we progress through the course. Next up is the cloud auditor. And what NIST is talking about here is the party who makes independent assessments of that cloud service. NIST actually defines the auditor as being a party that can perform an independent examination of the cloud service controls. Now, what they're talking about here is verifying conformance to standards, and inevitably any major cloud provider is going to have an auditor that can perform that task. Organizations put a huge amount of trust in the cloud, so conforming to this cloud reference architecture in terms of actually having someone audit things like security, privacy, and performance is pretty essential when you're offering a cloud service. Next up is the cloud broker. And now we're talking about the entity which manages the relationship between the cloud providers and the consumers of that cloud. They take care of things like service intermediation, service aggregation, and service arbitrage. This starts to become a bit of an academic definition of how the cloud should work. But again, just given the role of NIST and how important these reference architectures are, it's important to at least touch on it during this course. Finally, there is the cloud carrier. So now we're talking about the intermediary who actually provides the connectivity and transport services between the cloud consumers and providers. Telcos, for example, are a pretty important cloud carrier. So that's NIST's cloud computing reference architecture. And that's the last we're going to talk about NIST. I now want to go on and talk about just one more thing before we start touching on security. And that's the promise of the cloud. So what do organizations hope to gain from moving to the cloud?